My father had fought in World War I for the as a German. And he was raised, hooray for the Kaiser. He marched for his grandfather. So the idea that he lost his job and the edicts that began to come out were hard to believe. So he said, this will pass. So he went and opened up a little manufacturing business. Mother, a very great entrepreneur lady, went and became the cutter, and my father traveled the provinces, sold clothes, aprons, and house dresses, something we don't even know here. Anyway, they continued this little business, and I know that for me, several things were clear. One is there was a bench that I loved to sit on in front of our house. Suddenly it said, dogs and Jews not allowed. We used to go to a park as a group. Suddenly, we weren't allowed to enter that park. So as a child, the other thing that I heard was my father would say, ich sehe schwarz, I see black, meaning when he heard the radio, that was his response. So the decision was made that maybe discussions were going on. Argentina. I wake up in the morning, I hear, yo soy tu es, nosotros somos. Okay. And the next thing we know, Argentina says, finito no juice. And then, begin to sense, I recall, a certain tenseness begins to develop. And that goes out each day, looking to see where we can go. One morning I wake up and I hear, I am, you are, we are, they are, between my parents lying in bed saying the verbs in English instead of Spanish. So I knew something had changed. And the next thing I know is we are being hosted by family in Breslau, in the town I was born, because we were going to the Philippines. And that's all I knew. House was being dissolved and packed. We came to the, we took a 4-week trip on a ship, a French liner, and arrived in the Philippines, and we were met by my family's, my uncle, who had come a month before. They had a daughter, Lottie, who was my age, and we were like twins. Now, the grown-ups have their story, but I will tell you Lottie and my story. Lottie said to me, you won't believe it, so the minute we come to the little hotel where we stayed, it was run by a little Russian lady. We were on Lourdes Street. You know Harrison Avenue has Corbinier, Progress, and so forth. It crosses Lourdes Street. At the end of Lourdes Street, she grabbed me and took me to the end, and what did I see? An ocean, and she said, there's stuff in it. And we went, climbed over the little barricade, and there we saw snails and shells, and it was very, very exciting. For us children, these were the exciting things. We went to school at Santa Escolastica for 2 years, but being too religious, we then moved, which to me was one of the most important things. We went to Philippine Women's University, which I can only say I returned to them, and it was for me returning home to love and caring and attention. It was overwhelming. I visited them the first thing when I came. Anyhow, my dad was an entrepreneur. He got a loan from Mr. Frieder, who was a conduit for American Jewish money, and which was the joint, the American Jewish Joint Distribution Committee. He got the money, got a driver, Then mother, who was a very active lady, went to Chinatown, began to argue and discuss with the Chinese. She bought watches, pens, buttons, snaps, etc. And dad traveled the entire country from Benguet mines to Ilocos Norte to Cebu selling. And here again, the open heart accompanying open policy for us. He had a Filipino driver, Jesus Delisay. I will never forget him. He was my father's bodyguard. He was my father's geographic teacher because he knew the country and it was a good enterprise. One small story, they came to a small town, and in that small town was no hotel. I went, what'd you do? What? Jesus said, you're not sleeping in the hotel. It's not sleeping in the car. Too dangerous. And what did they do? They went to the police and said, would you put us in prison overnight?